Let's look at another example. This is rotation of a rigid body about a fixed point. Okay. So rotation of a rigid body about a fixed point. So we have a rigid body. Let's say this is rotating about a fixed point O, okay? And here is the center of mass. It turns out that when you have a situation like this, a rigid body is rotating about a fixed point, we can simplify the second Newton-Euler law somewhat, okay? So we still have the first one, which is sigma f equal to m times the acceleration of center of mass. The second one says that sigma mg is equal to ig alpha, or if you were to write it in the general form, we've seen this is equal to ig alpha plus r of g with zero point q plus m times acceleration of center of mass, right? So now let's say we are going to choose our reference point q to be this fixed point of rotation, okay? So q is equal to o. So that means we are doing sigma m o equal to ig alpha, nothing changes about the first term, plus r of g with respect to o, so that's basically this position vector, cross m times ag, okay? Now, let's look at what AG really is, right? So we can write AG is equal to, choosing O as a reference point, a little bit of kinematic analysis, which is 0 because it's a fixed point, minus omega squared R of G with respect to O. So let's say the angular velocity is omega and acceleration is alpha, plus alpha cross R of G with respect to O, right? So it turns out for a rigid body moving about a fixed point, we can write this kinematic analysis, and when we substitute for this AG in here, we will achieve some simplification. So what do we get? We get sigma MO equal to IG alpha plus R of G, which is O cross. Let's substitute this. We get minus omega squared plus alpha cross R of G, which is O. So this cross product with this is going to be 0, so we are left with Ig alpha plus R of G with zero to O cross alpha cross R of G with zero to O, right? So this is basically doing again A cross B cross C, which is equal to A dot C times B minus A dot B times C, right? Okay, so let's do that. So we have Ig alpha plus this dotted with itself will be R squared G with zero to O. And then, of course, we forgot the M here, right? We have MAG, so this is actually M here, the M here, and M here. That times alpha minus A dot B. So this dotted with alpha, you know, is going to be 0 because this is a motion in a plane. Alpha is perpendicular plane, and these position vectors are in the plane. So that's actually 0. So what do we get? We get, we also have alpha here. So we get IG plus mr squared g with this to O times alpha. Now, this is an interesting quantity. What is this? This is saying this is the centroidal mass moment of inertia plus m times the distance squared between O and the center of mass, right? And from parallax's theorem, you know that this is actually the mass moment of inertia about the fixed point O. So this reduces to sigma mo equal to io alpha. So this is valid only if rigid body is rotating about fixed point O. So please don't use this relationship unless you can clearly see that point O is a fixed point of rotation. Okay, if point O is not a fixed point of rotation, which has zero velocity, zero acceleration, then please don't use this relationship. On the other hand, sigma mg equal to ig alpha, this equation over here can be used in any circumstance, okay? And same is the case with this one, all right? So here is another interesting example. This is the example 7.5 from the text. And in this example, we're looking for the sweet spot of a baseball bat. So if you have played baseball or any game like that, which involves bat and the ball, you know that if you don't hit the ball properly, it can hurt your hands, right? But on the other hand, sometimes you may have experienced that if you hit the ball in the right spot on your bat, then you don't feel a lot of forces transferred to your hand, okay? So the point where the ball hits the bat such that you feel very little lateral forces transmitted to your hand is called the sweet spot of a bat, okay? And it's also sometimes called the center of percussion. So in this particular problem, we have a bat, and we are given that the bat is holding the bat at point O, okay? So this is a little bit far away from the end of the bat, right? And this distance is being called delta. And the technical term for this is that the batter has choked the bat by distance delta. And we know this, where the center of mass G is located. This is the end B. And then let's say the ball strikes the bat at point P, okay? And the distance from point A to G is also known, so that's L. So we know the geometry of the bat, so we know all these things. And D is that distance where the ball should be hit by the bat, so that you feel very little force in the transfer direction where you hold the bat, okay? So these are some of the things given to you in the problem. Of course, you know what delta is, so given in this problem are delta as 2 inches, and you're also given the weight of the bat, so you know the mass of the bat, you also know the length in this case, and you know the mass moment of inertia of the bat as well, okay? So the first step is, of course, to draw the coordinate system. So let's say, you know, this is our coordinate system, it's on y-axis, and we have to do the kinematic analysis. So what kind of kinematic analysis we can do? Well, let's try to identify the motion of this, right? So this is basically a rotation about point O, right? So this is almost as if there is a rigid body, right? And this rigid body is hinged at point O, which means it can only do rotation, right? Which means that we can probably apply our simplified Newton-Euler equation in this case. So, but let's go ahead with the kinematic analysis first. So our goal is to find acceleration of center of mass as well as the angular acceleration of the bat, right? Okay. We know that this rigid body is rotating about point O, so we can write something about acceleration of center of mass choosing O as a reference point, which is zero, and that is equal to this minus omega square r of g with respect to O plus alpha k hat cross r of g with respect to O, and that is minus omega square r of g, so O is L minus delta, so that distance is L minus delta, and that's actually going to be I hat, okay, plus alpha, also L minus delta, and this is going to be along J direction, right? So K cross I, that's J. So alpha, L minus delta, J hat. So that's the acceleration of center of mass, okay? Now, from this, of course, you know, we don't know what omega is, we don't know what alpha is, right? And we also don't know what D is. D is something we don't know. Okay. So that's all we can do in terms of kinematic analysis. Let's now proceed with the free body diagram. So I'm going to draw this again, but without the ball. Okay, so this point O. So reaction at point O, right? So that reaction would come from the hand, because you're going to be holding the bat at point O. So your hand is going to be supporting the bat, right? And these are the forces that you're applying. So we're assuming that OI is the lateral direction force, and OX is the longitudinal direction force, right? So OX will have a tendency to slip out of your hand. So if you didn't apply any force in the X direction, then the bat would slip out of your hand essentially. But if you apply any friction, then that friction basically would be the OX. And then OI is the sort of perpendicular direction force on your hand. So, okay. What else do we have? We have a reaction, right, over here. So that's applied at point D. So the point D is from here to here. That's point D. And this is the end point A. That's end point B. And we have already seen this distance is delta, right? So these are all the forces acting. Of course, you also have the gravity acting through the center of mass, but we're not concerned with that because the gravity is actually acting perpendicular to the plane of this figure, right? So we're not really concerned with that. But you do need a normal reaction to keep it in your hand. So you can imagine that there is a vertical direction reaction also acting at point O that would support the weight of the bat, right? Okay, so let's do analysis. Sigma F equal to M times acceleration of center of mass. So we have OX, I hat, plus OY, plus R, j hat equal to mass times acceleration, which is this quantity here, right? So let's write that. Minus omega square L minus delta I hat plus alpha L minus delta J hat. Okay. So from this, we get Ox equal to minus M omega square L minus delta. And we get Oy plus R equal to M alpha L minus delta. Right? Okay. Then we can use the other equation, which is sigma mg equal to ig alpha, right? So let's take the moment about center of mass. So if we do that, then we have the moment of r, which is r times the distance is d minus delta. So that's d minus delta, and that's positive. There is no moment of ox because it's going through center of mass. Then we have minus oy, and that is at a distance of d minus delta. No, it's not d minus delta actually. This is L. From here to here is L. So that's L minus delta. L minus delta equal to ig times alpha, right? And at this point, I am not writing the vectors because this is only along perpendicular direction, perpendicular to the plane of this figure. So, you know, positive and negative will take care of the other things, right? Okay, so from these, we can now see what are the unknowns. We are looking for basically the condition when the transverse direction force Oy would be zero, right? So we're looking for Oy to be zero. We don't want any transverse direction or lateral direction force to be transmitted to the hand. And under those conditions, we are looking for what the D would be, right? We're looking for what the D would be. So let's count the number of unknowns we have over here, okay? So we have Ox over here. We have Oy. We have R is given to us, right? R is given to us. And then we have the alpha. So let's solve this. So Oy is zero. So this gives us R equal to M alpha L minus delta, okay, which we can substitute in here. Okay, so let's do that. So we have M alpha L minus delta times D minus delta, and the second term is zero, so that is equal to IG alpha. All right, so alpha cancels. That's great. So now from this equation, actually, we can solve for D. So D minus delta is IG over M times L minus delta. So D is equal to delta plus IG over M times L minus delta. So we know the delta, we know the L, we know the IG. So from this, we can compute what the D would be. And of course, this D should be within the length of the bat, right? If it comes out to be beyond the length of the bat, then we know there's something wrong, right? So this gives you basically the distance where the ball should ideally be hit by the bat so that you will feel as little transverse direction force as possible. In reality, of course, it will never be zero because it will be very hard to find the exact center of percussion, but you can try to get close to it with practice. So it turns out that, you know, this kind of analysis is useful for designing machines where you want as little force to be transmitted to the structures of the machine. So for example, there is a machine that tests for the impact resistance of the materials. So it's an impact testing machine, a pendulum type machine. So something like, you know, you have a pendulum, right? You know, and this is a very heavy mass attached over here, and you have a specimen which is kept over here, and then this pendulum essentially swings and hits against this specimen. Okay, so you want this pendulum to swing and hit against the specimen at a point which possibly might be the center of percussion for this pendulum. If that's the case, then the forces, let's call this Ox, and you know, let's call this Oy and Ox, then you want to minimize this transverse direction force. Okay, so if it hits at the center of percussion, the sweet spot, then you will minimize the forces transmitted to the structure of the machine.